always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. So originally this episode was going to be the one game against Miami at the end of September, but the thing is, as we went to go, we recorded it, it was a great overall game, it was pretty good, I guess. And I went to go edit it up, but this frame rate was a mess, though, it was unbearable to even edit up, so unfortunately, the game will not be uploaded on the channel. So we apologize in advance, and we're going to go start this episode with the end of the season. Finished over 500 this season, though, 82-80, I think that makes our coach goal, too, because I think our goal was to make it over 500, so it's not that bad. But regular season has come to an end. And let's go and check out the last few games. So Miami won 76-0 in that game. Won 4-3 in that game, too, with Jordan Lyles getting the W. But actually, one game I want to check out, though, was the game where Jeff Hoffman actually won, though. He actually won this game. So this game, we do have Jeff Hoffman getting this W here. He's got 7 innings pitched, 4 hits, 1 earned run, 1 walk, 8 and 6 strikeouts in that game. So killer game for Jeff Hoffman. Finally got a W on the season. And it's probably his best game of his career so far as a Rocky. But nonetheless, I might as well just go check out this Dodgers series, though. I think he lost that one 2-1, but first game, Jeff Hoffman took the loss. He better not have gotten like 5 runs driven in on him, though. What did his day look like? Of course, they had Kershaw in an 8 innings pitch, 6 hits, 1 run, 2 walks, and 12 strikeouts. Huge game for Clayton Kershaw, but we have Jeff Hoffman, 7 hits, 4 runs, 2 walks, and 1 strikeout in that game for Jeff. But might as well go and check out our season in review. We finished 82-80. I'm going to go check out what our standings were for this season. So Dodgers, 98 wins on the season. We have the Giants, 89 wins. They went to the playoffs. So, I mean, pretty good overall season for the NL West. Whereas we're 82-80. We have the Diamondbacks, 80-82. So pretty close there. Then there's the Padres in a league of their own. The Toilet Bowl League, 59 wins, 103 losses. Terrible season for the Padres. So I'm pretty sure they're last in MLB, were they? They had to have been last. If they're not last, and they probably were pretty close to being last. And they were last. Dead last in the entire MLB are the Padres. The Padres, a huge mess there. They got to figure out what they're doing before anything gets even worse there. But this season, though, our hitting was just atrocious, though. The entire season was just a mess when it comes to hitting the baseball. So we got to really rethink our lineup and maybe bring in some bigger hitters on this team, because we're second in defense, great defensive team, first in speed, 13th in contact, 14th in power, 19th in pitching, so you gotta bring in some pitching prospects, or even just pitching in general, like some relief guys, and maybe bring in some power guys too. I want to get some big hitters, like Cargo. We lost him, obviously, in favor of Vladimir Guerrero Jr., so that's one prospect we added to the system that has some power, so you gotta find some guys in the free agency, maybe even a Jose Bautista-like guy to go and bring in at right field, possibly to go in place for now, because Vladdy's not gonna be ready for a few more years, so you gotta wait for that to happen, but now let's go see what the overall MLB was for W's. So the Cubs, 108 wins, 54 losses, huge season for them. The Pirates, 90-72, 107-55 Nationals on the season, 87-75 Mets, they missed the playoffs. With the 92-70 Red Sox there, and the 86-76 Yankees there in the wild card in the American League. The West, American League West, we have 92 wins and 70 losses from the Angels. 94 wins, 88 losses, or 68 losses, sorry, from the Indians. Then the American League East, the Blue Jays, 100 wins on the season, 62 losses, 92 from the Red Sox. So huge year for the American League East, though. Huge year, though. They play great. So let's go ahead and actually check out what our league leaders were in every statistical category. So you have Joey Votto there, number one in batting average in the National League. American League, you have Miguel Cabrera there, a huge, great season for him, though. We have John Donaldson at 306, Detroit at 308, and so on and so forth. So take a look at some of these guys. Like a guy like Cole Calhoun, I'd love to get on this team, though. Cole Calhoun, he's only 29 years old, 85 overall. If we can get this man on our team, huge upside for us, though. How many years left does he have on his deal, though? He's in his last year, and I think he's got a few more years, though. I believe he does. So we'd have to acquire Cole Calhoun if we could, maybe via a trade, trading some prospects for Cole, because our team, and I think his ability to compete, though, next year, hopefully it does, because, I mean, we finished over 500 this season. Want to go and branch out to go maybe make the playoffs next season. So if Cole Calhoun up there for a possible possible player we could pick up next season. Then we have like some of these guys, like Melky Cabrera is not that bad either. We have Jose Abreu, you have Robinson Cano on there. I mean, pretty decent overall guys to pick up, though. Even Victor Martinez, he's 80 overall. Oh, he's 38 years old, though. He's probably going to retire. But everything else, though, not that bad for the American League for possible players. But in the National League, we have Anthony Rizzo, David Peralta, Hunter Pence, Starling Marte. Where is one of our batters, though?
Ian Desmond, their 10th, their 293. He was great this season, though. Huge season for first season as a Rocky for Ian Desmond, though. I took out Ian Desmond's season. So he had, what'd he do? He had 160 hits, 15 home runs, 72 RBI. So lower than last year, but still, he played great, though, for the Rockies this season. So I guess it's a pretty good. We lost a draft pick for him, so he basically performed well enough to basically cover that draft pick, because he's great this season. But let's move on to the next thing, which is hits. Starling Marte and Joey Votto there in hits. Anything else, though? Where's our hitter? Where is Ian Desmond? There he is, 18th. Tied for 18th. Not that bad, I guess. But at bats, we have Starling Marte. Doubles, we have Starling Marte. Ian Desmond, their second in doubles, though. 48 doubles in the season for Ian Desmond. Killer season for him. Triples, of course, the 99 overall speed. D. Gordon, though, he killed us too in that Miami game, though. Like, D. Gordon and Stanton in the outfield is just, or not in the outfield, but Stanton and D. Gordon overall is just amazing to have on your team, though. But home runs, Stanton 44, of course. We have Grichuk had 41, Seager at 39, 35 from Brandon Belt. Where's one of our hitters, though? Where is, what's his face? Nolan Arenado. Where's Holy Noly? Is he even up here? Or did I miss him? I don't know. Yeah, I definitely missed him. He had 30 on the season, did he? And he finished with, yeah, there he is, 14-30 home runs on the season. So, I guess he kind of underperformed. I thought he had 40, but it's all right, though. Our team played terrible as a whole. So, maybe it was a team thing and brought down his morale in general. But, let's see, RBI. We have Chris Bryant there, led the league 113. And looks like for the American League, though, Mike Trout, 124, though, he led the American League there. But I don't see, where is Nolan Arenado? 98 only on the season, so not the overall RBI king this season was Nolan Arenado, which kind of sucks. But we have home runs, we have obviously Giancarlo Stanton with those home runs, and we do have, where is our hitters here? It's going to take a while to go through our hitters, though. Where is our hitters? There is Nolan Arenado, 95, or 25 there, 25th on the league. But stolen bases, we do have D. Gordon and Villar, Billy Hamilton, Eduardo Nunez. Like, some of these speedy guys I'd love to pick up, but we have Charlie Blackman there fourth, so, I mean, Blackman is great this season, too, for stolen bases. Other than that, though, like, batting average is terrible, too, though. 245 is not great at all. I think he batted over 300 last season in real life, so, huge downfall from last year was Blackman. But, you have Sterling Marte there, D. Gordon, Villar. Like, Villar would be great to pick up, too. Wouldn't be that bad to pick up there for maybe the infield, I'm not really sure. But, we have base on balls, Matt Carpenter, Anthony Rizzo, and so on. On base percentage, we have Anthony Rizzo, Joey Votto, Bryce Harper, Ismani Grandal. We have Andrew McCutcheon, Hunter Pence, Jason Wirth. And slugging percentage, we have the man himself, Giancarlo Stanton, 583. Huge killer season for Stanton. And we have McCutcheon, Votto, Granderson, Bryce Harper, and so on. OPS, we have Joey Votto and Stanton. Wins, we have John Lester, though. 20 wins on the season. He led the overall MLB in wins. I want to see where our pitchers were, though. Where were our pitchers? And we do not. We have Anderson there, 14th. Tied for 14th. There are 13 wins in the season, I think, is what we have. Is it? And it is. So, this is a brutal season overall for our pitchers. But where is, actually, losses, I don't even want to know. I don't want to know that. Saves, we do have Wade Davis there for the Cubs. Where is some of our players? Where is Adam Ottavino? There he is, though. 10th. With 40 overall, so he's great this season for us. We have ERA, Jeff Samardzija, though, the king of the National League in ERA was Jeff Samardzija there, 192. You have Steven Strasburg, 198. Patrick Corbin, 222. You have Clayton Kershaw, 230, though. I thought he'd be below 2, but I guess not. You have Noah Syndergaard, Thor, 230 there. Syndergaard, I'd love to pick up, though. I mean, they have a lot of pitchers that are in the Mets system, so, I mean, what's one less, though? What's one less? So that'd be kind of funny to pick up Thor on the season, though. That'd be pretty good for us. But we do have Anderson, though. The 254, though. Great season for Anderson, though. I thought he played very well for what kind of system we're in right now. Because we're basically a team that was tanking and competing at the same time, though. I don't know what we were doing, basically. But we do have, like, his overall went up, though. 82 overall, so he's gone up a bit, though. I think he's like a 78 to start off the season. So, I mean, there's a lot of potential from Tyler Anderson that's being fulfilled right now. So, got to keep him in the system for next year. We have Max Scherzer there, Jake Arrieta, Jacob deGrom. Even deGrom I'd love to pick up, though, too. So, there's another guy I could probably add to the list for possible pickups. Anyone else? John Gray, 20th. With 311, though. So, John Gray played very well, I thought, for the season, though. I thought he'd suck, but 311's not that bad, though. Then, home runs allowed, don't really care too much about that. Shutouts, Johnny Cueto with 4. Strikeouts, you have Max Scherzer there. We have Alex Reyes, the rookie himself there, with how many? 224, huge season for him. You have John Gray, 197. So Gray and Anderson were the bright spots of our team this season, basically. They played great for us. Same with Ian Desmond, too. So it's Desmond, Gray, and Anderson all played very well for us this season. Same with Fernando Salazar, though, too, at relief. But at big games, you have Clayton Kershaw, innings pitcher John Cueto, John Lester, and so on. Walks allowed, you have Ivan Nova, we have Steven Strasburg, Thor. Whip, we do have Noah Syndergaard there, Thor. We have John Lester, Max Scherzer, Steven Strasburg, Jeff Samardzija, Johnny Cueto, Talon Walker, and so on. Pitching worry of Noah Syndergaard, so Syndergaard's playing very well, though. He could even be up there for MVP, possibly, so it'd be pretty good if he won that. But we have Ken... Where else? Where's our pitchers, though? Wait, there's John Gray. The 15th overall is not that bad, though. I thought he'd be way down there. But John Gray, he's up there for worth 4.2. Then we have batting order with Sterling Marte, easily 7.6. You have Joey Votto there, we have Bryce Harper. Where is Stanton, though? I thought Stanton would be up there, but I guess not. But Granderson, 6.5. Paul Goldschmidt, 6.2. Grandel's up there, and there's Stanton at 5. But anything else, though? That's about it. Batting average, though, I think we basically went around. So that was the entire stats, though. Took a while to get through, but had to get through it, though, nonetheless. But stats overall for our team, I took a brief look at it before the Miami game, but might as well take a refresh at that before we do anything else. Home runs, Nolan Arenado with 30 home runs in the season, Blackman with 21. Trevor Story, 17, because he's injured for half the season, though. You gotta remember that. He's barely even there, because he had 108 games played compared to, like, 158 from Arenado, so... I mean, he just didn't have enough games played, though. If he would have had more, though, he probably would have hit over 30 home runs. I'm calling that. And he had 48 RBI in the season. We have 15 home runs from Ian Desmond himself, 11 from Patterson, 10 from LeMahieu, 8 from Garneau, 7 from Pera, 7th from Mark Reynolds, 6 from David Dahl, 2 from Brad, and 1 from Tony Walters, and 1 from Anthony Gose. RBI, we have 98 from Nolan Arenado, the RBI king. Used to be, but now he's not anymore. We have 74 from Blackman, 72 from Desmond, 49 from LeMahieu, 48 from Story, 42 from David Dahl, 36 from Jordan Patterson, 30 from Pera, and 28 from Garneau, and so on down there. Stolen bases easily was our man, Blackman, though. 29 this season, huge for us. We have Brad, though, even he only played... How many games? 49 games played. He had 15 stolen bases. So, I mean, Brad would be a guy I'd love to pick up, though. Maybe get some more guys with stealing ability who could run the bases, too. So, it'd be pretty good to pick up some more stealers on the team. You have 13 from Ian Desmond, 7 from David Dahl, and so on down there. But batting average, though, you have 303 from Mark Reynolds, 293 from everyday player Ian Desmond, 266 from the rookie Jordan Patterson, 262 from Brad, you have a 253 from Nolan Arenado, 247 from Tony Walters, and that's pretty much it, though. Going down there is just disappointing, though, just seeing how bad our team was at batting. But we have Mark Reynolds there for OBP. Anything else? You have slugging percentage. We do have... Mark Reynolds right there. OPS, we do have Mark Reynolds. Looks like walks, we do have DJ LeMahieu. Looks like strikeouts, Ian Desmond. And doubles, Ian Desmond. Triples, Blackman. And total bases, looks like Arenado. So, I mean, let's go through all the rest of the stats right here. But right now this season, just terrible overall for hitting. I thought we had a terrible season when it came to hitting. But wait, stolen bases though. Looks like Nolan Arenado, 104 stolen bases. Same with Anthony Gose, Brad, and... Looks like Jordan Patterson. So Brad, easily the best stealer on the season, though. He played very well for us. So if we can get Brad back for next season, it'd be great to have him on the bench once again. But assists, DJ LeMahieu, putouts, we do have Justin Garneau, and that's pretty much it, though. We'll check out WAR, though. Batting WAR, we do have Nolan Arenado at a 4.2, 4.1 from Ian Desmond, 3.8 from Charlie Blackman, 2 from Trevor Story. Who's below 1, though? We do have below 1 from Jordan Patterson and Garneau and Pera. But, yeah, it's basically our season, though, in a nutshell. Our team is terrible batting, and that's basically why we're not in a playoff spot right now. But let's go to our pitchers, though, pitchers. So, easily our best pitcher was Tyler Anderson in the season, a 3-3-7 record on the season, 184 for innings pitched, 49 overall walks, 164 strikeouts, and a 2.54 ERA is insane for Tyler Anderson. But for wins, we have John Gray, they're 12-10 from... Looks like Chatwood, and the rest is history down there. Then losses, we have John Gray, 15 losses. That's why Like, some of these guys cannot get anything together. It could be just because their bats weren't clicking when they're playing. Like, they didn't get run support. But Stephen Wright at 10 there. Wright played very well for the first half of the season. Then, like, when it went to the down, like, the nitty-gritty, he just played like crap, though. Just honestly played like crap. But 30 or 40 overall saves from Admontovino. Innings pitch, we have Tyler Anderson and so on. Walks, we have Tyler Chatwood. We have strikeouts, we have John Gray. ERA, we do have, that looks like Stephen Wright, though, is our worst guy with ERA. Then we have Carlos Estevez, Wild Thing. You have Jordan Walden there with a 4.17. Robbie Ray, who's injured right now, at 4.06. Chalbot at 3.30. 3.13 from Mike Dunn. So our starting pitching was great this season, though. Besides, it looks like Stephen Wright, though, he was crap for us. But we do have Robbie Ray there. Wait, let's want to see the better whip, though. It looks like Jake McGee there with a .98. Salas is a 1.16, and that's about it. So, I mean, other than that, though, our season was not that bad for pitching, though. Our pitching was one of our bright spots. It just, we didn't get run support for our pitchers, though. That's why we didn't really play that well. But anyway, that was our stats for the season. Our season was very disappointing, but next season will be different, though. We'll get some guys into the system. They'll play very well for us and hopefully get us into a playoff spot next season or even a wildcard spot. But, let's go check out awards though for the season. So awards, it's time to go and celebrate as Nolan Arenado, another gold glove to the mantle. I believe it's like 4 or 5 in a row though. Don't check me on that. But so let's check out awards here for the MLB. So it looks like MVP goes to John Lester of the Cubs. They're 250 ERA, 207 strikeouts, and 20-3 record on the season. Insane for John Lester. But let's see, Cy Young. Of course, John Lester there. He's the best pitcher in the National League. Batting title goes to Joey Votto. Reliever of the year goes to Wade Davis of the Cubs. Rookie of the year goes to Alex Reyes. Hank Aaron goes to Joey Votto. Gold Glove pitcher goes to Joe Ross. Gold Glove catcher goes to Travis d'Arnaud. It looks like Gold Glove first base, Eric Hosmer, who's now on the Nationals, though. The Nationals probably going to win it all there in the MLB. But second base, we do have Javier Baez. Third base, we do have Nolan Arenado, obviously. Shortstop, we do have Edini Hecavera. Hecavera? I can't really say that. I'm sorry I can't say it. But looks like Edini, though, did win it for Gold Glove shortstop. But left field, we have Marcelo Ozuna. Center field, we have Endar Suarte. And right field, we do have Bryce Harper. Then Silver Slugger pitcher, we do have Clayton Kershaw. Catcher, we do have Buster Posey. First base, we do have Joey Votto. Second base, we have Dan the Man Murphy. Third base, we do have Chris Bryant. Shortstop, we have Corey Seager. Outfield, we do have Randall Grichik. Who else is on there? Giancarlo Stanton, they're one at 4 outfield, too. And same with Starling Marte. Then postseason MVP still has to be up for debate right now. And yeah, it's about it there for the National League. But now on to the American League. MVP does go to Mike Trout there for the second year in a row. He won it last year, so back-to-back MVPs by Mike Trout. So next up is Yu Darvish there for Cy Young. Batting title goes to Miguel Cabrera. Reliever of the year goes to Edwin Diaz. Easily, though, he was great this season. Rookie of the year goes to Aaron Judge there of the Yankees. Hank Aaron goes to Mike Trout. Gold Glove pitcher goes to Wade Miley. Catcher goes to Blake Swihart. First base, we do have Chris Davis. Second base, you have Dustin Pedroia. Third base, you do have Manny Machado. Shortstop, you do have Francisco Lindor. Left field, we do have Brett Gardner. Center field, we do have Kevin Kiermaier. And right field, we do have Mookie Betts. So now on the Silver Slugger DH, we do have Matt Holliday. Catcher, we do have Gary Sanchez, the Beast. First base, we do have Miggy. Second base, we do have Jose Altuve. Third base, we do have Manny Machado. Shortstop, we do have Carlos Correa. Outfield, we do have Mike Trout, George Springer, and Nelson Cruz. So those are all your awards for the MLB this season, though. Great overall award winners, though. Like, now that almost all those guys deserve it, though. Like, I didn't really see any guy, any player that kind of stood out because they didn't deserve it because they all played well this season. But actually, I want to check out one thing, though. One thing. Hold up. I saw something earlier on the Jays. So I'm going to go to rotation. Because I think the Jays have one of the best rotations in the entire league. Take a look at this, though. 250 overall ERA from Marcus Stroman. 239 from Aaron Sanchez. A 232 from Gavin Floyd. A 262 from Jay Happ. And a 387 from Francisco Liriano. So, I mean, like, three of these starters have an ERA under 3, which is insane for the American League. So, I just put your hands together for the Blue Jays, though. They played very well for their pitching and got 100 wins on the season. But, I guess now is on to playoff time for the rest of the league. Not for us, the rest of the league, because we suck this season overall. So let's go sim a few days and see when the playoffs start and so on. Because I want to see these brackets and stuff. Let's go to... Actually, I want to see... Well, I'll just wait until the playoffs are done, though. Sim through the 31st. And the Red Sox have won the 2017 World Series against the Nationals. So, huge season for the Red Sox. I want to check out the bracket, though, and see how they won this season. So It looks like the Red Sox went to the wild card. In fact, they won against the New York Yankees. They went and won against Toronto 3-1. They went and won against the LA Angels 4-3. They went and moved on to the World Series and won 4-1 against the Nationals. So, great overall season from the Red Sox. One of the best teams in baseball, and they deserved it this season. But I want to see the losers, though, the Washington Nationals, who are one of the best teams in baseball. I don't know how they choked it, but they had a great lineup, though. I thought they would have won it for sure, but I guess not for the NL. But it looks like the Nationals, they went and started off 1-3-1, or 3-2 there, against the Dodgers in the NLDS. And then the NLCS, they won 4-1 against the Cubs, and then they moved on to the World Series and lost 4-1 against the Red Sox. So that was the playoffs for 2017. Pretty lame, I guess, considering we're not in it, but still pretty cool that the Red Sox won it, though. Let's see awards of who won World Series MVP. So, looks like Hanley Ramirez won World Series MVP for the Red Sox, and looks like your postseason MVP was Adam Eaton from the Nationals. So, the loser and the winner both take home awards individually there for Hanley Ramirez and Adam Eaton there in the World Series. But nonetheless, move on to the next thing, which is our offseason, and see when our offseason actually starts, though. Okay, so let's move on here. So, we do have... It looks like our contract with the first base coach is now up. So right now, coaching staff, I can finally go and fire them, because the reason why you guys kept saying, go and fire the coaching staff, they're doing a terrible job right now. And I agreed with you guys, but the thing is I couldn't hire or fire anybody based on the fact that we had no money to go and spend to go and hire and fire guys. So now it is up to go and do our coaching staff over again, though. Like, get rid of everybody, practically, if they're bad enough. Okay, you got qualifying offers and retired players first. So, retired players, Anthony Ghost retired, we have Brad retired, TJ House retired, and Ordonez retired, though, damn it. So, we have Ordonez, I thought he'd play great for us, he retired, TJ House is gone, Brad's gone, or Matt, I thought he'd play well for us next season as a stolen base guy, but I guess didn't want to stick around. But the other Anthony Ghost there, too, who even retired, which kind of sucks, but he doesn't really matter too much to us. But we have Ichiro Suzuki, the legend himself, retired due to age. We have Nick Vogel, Jason Grilly, Grilly Cheese retired for the Blue Jays, and any other big names, though, any other big names? Doesn't look like it, though, too much. We have Dan Vogt from the Athletics, not Steven Vogt, but Carlos Beltran retired from the Astros, he's gonna be a legend. Anyone else? Bartolo Colon, Big Sexy retired, damn it. So Big Sexy and R.A. Dickey both retired from the Braves due to age. Anyone else, though, that's big? Trevor Bryant, not Chris Bryant. Anybody else here, though, that I know? Doesn't look like it, though, too much. There's a lot of no-name guys retired due to poor free agent market. But anybody else who retired due to age, though, it's a legend. There's a lot, though. Yeah, it looks like there isn't any. So, there's Ichiro and Beltran, Big Sexy, and R.A. Dickey, both all retired for this season that are pretty notable names. The same with Grilly Cheese, though, too, from the Jays. But let's see this, though. Our Hall of Fame inductees are Carlos Beltran and Ichiro Suzuki from the Orioles. So put your hands together for Ichiro and Carlos. They're moving on to the Hall of Fame. Let's move on to the next thing, which is our offseason. So offseason, right now it's time to go to hire and fire some coaches because our bench is just terrible, though. We'll get Vic Reynolds. He's going to be gone because I don't want him. We have Dale. We do have enough money, though. That's the thing. Do we have enough money? I'll fire the guys we don't need, like Steven Abbott. He's terrible. He's a B. Okay. So our new manager, though, we gotta go hire a new manager. There's Joe Madden, Alfonso Fish. Joe Madden I'll go and make an offer for. So he wants like $7 million, though. Huge contract, though. We'll go and offer it him, though. We'll offer it. So we only have... How much money do we have, though? I think we only have like... Yeah, we only have like $9.4 million. Hold up. We have to split between three overall coaches, $9.4 million. We have, like, no money for going to get Joe Madden, though. Any other cheaper guys, though. Any other cheaper guys. Like, even, like, Tyler Esposito, though. How much does he want? 4 years per million. 4 years, not that bad. For a bench boss. We have this dude, Doyle Malai. Anybody else in here, though? Mickey Callaway is a pretty nice name. So he wants $4.3 million per year. Any other cheap guys, though? You have Sammy Law. Okay. 4.1 for per year again. Anybody else here? You have Bobby or Robbie Tejeda. He wants 3.8, so we'll offer Robbie one, I guess. We'll offer him that because plate discipline is huge for me, though. We have Ronald Green. He wants 3.7, so even less than that. So right now we'll offer Robbie Tejeda, and I think Ronald Green will leave off for now. But pitching coach, though, pitching coach. Do we have any other good pitching coaches we can go and hire? We do have Josh on here as the big fish right here. Maybe go and try and hire him, though. We'll offer him that. Because it doesn't really matter too much as long as we get some guys. Like, even this dude, though, he's not that bad. Even this dude on here, he wants 1.1. So offer all those guys some contracts just in case, though. That, like, what if one guy backs out, then we're fine, basically. So go and just go and hire some more managers, though, just in case. Like, even Mickey Callaway, how much does he want? 4.3. I'll get a guy who wants like, 3.7. Like, even this dude, Lane Bacon. Pretty funny name. Or Bakken. Yeah, this dude, Jim Hickey. There you go. Like, Jim Hickey actually looks like... Wait, hold up. Jim Hickey looks like John Gibbons in a way, doesn't he? Hold up, where is Jim Hickey? He kind of looks like John Gibbons in a way, though, doesn't he? Kind of does, actually. So there's Jim Hickey right there. Pitching coach, I think we're good there. First base, though, first base. Any dudes on here? We do have... I want to get a guy that has no negatives. Like this dude. So Ryan Heron. You have him on there. You have this dude at 990k. I'd love to get him, though. Any other dudes? This dude. 970k. So we're pretty good there, though. I think we'll at least get one of those guys off pitching coaches. So that's overall what we have right now for a team. Is there a way to get some cheaper guys there for farm director, though? Is there cheaper guys? So where's our farm directors? So much is he making? Like 800k? Oh, okay, we do have Earl Coker. We gave it. We can't even check how much they want, though. That's pretty weak if we can't, though. Okay, so I tell we can't even do anything. Yeah, we'll just hold off there. I think we're fine there. We don't need to go and fire Earl Coker because he's not that bad. Same with Kevin Weinstein, though, too. He's alright. So, I think now it might be next to go move on to the next thing, which is our managed contract. So we have a few guys that go and maybe offer arbitration too, but for the most part, I want to go and re-sign as many people as possible. So DJ LeMahieu, how much could we go and offer him? So it's 13.4 mil for per year, 5-year deal, not that bad right there. So it's a star role, and so on and so forth. So 13 per year is not that bad for DJ though. I love the man, might as well just go and re-sign him. So DJ, hopefully you come back for next season. But they have Charlie Blackman next on here, too. Well, it's 8.1 per season, so even lower than that, though. So I'll go and offer him that, too, I guess, whatever he wants. Even that's a little bit lower than he thought, though, or than he wants. I'll leave it there, though. I think it's fine. They have Taylor Anderson on there, too, the big fish this season. He played very well for us. We'll offer him that, just a little bit more. Right there. And then we do have Jordan Walden on there. How much does he want? 4.6. We'll leave off there. Then we do have David Dahl there, so we could offer we'll go and re-sign him, actually. We'll re-sign him. So 1.8 per year is not that bad for me. I'll do that deal. John Gray, he wants 4.1 per year. That's not that bad. We'll offer him that. Trevor Story himself, so he wants 5.4 per year. Might as well re-sign him. Carlos Estevez, wild thing. The 700k is pretty fine with me there, too. And then we have Jake McGee, who's 31 years old. I'll leave off right there, though. Fernando Salas, might as well re-sign him. 2.9 per year, that's pretty much worth it, though. Well, from a 3-year deal, how about that? 3-year deal. And just a little bit more money. We do that? No, we'll go 4 years. Right there. Anything else? So, yeah, Steven Wright here, 9.6 mil for 4 years. Might as well resign him there, I guess. Steven Wright was alright this season. Actually, wait, hold up. We'll hold out. Just for now, just in case. You have Mark Reynolds. Mark Reynolds, how much does he want? 1.9 per year. That's a little bit too much for me. Tyler Chatwood. He wants 3.5 per year, Tyler Chatwood. Ugh, he didn't really play that well to get that much money. Tony Walters, though, gotta re-sign that man. Anyone else? Chad Qualls, he's 39 years old, leave him. Robbie Ray, gotta re-sign him, obviously. So he wants 4.3 per year, though. Ugh. He just had an injury, too. So he only wants... we'll give him maybe 2.8. I'll give him 2.8, actually. Like, right there is good enough for me. 2 years, 2.8, not that bad of a deal for me. But we have Derek Garcia on here, gotta re-sign Derek. So now we're going down to, like, the more lower guys. I'll go 1 year for Pat. Giuseppe, re-sign him. Actually, no, we're not gonna re-sign Giuseppe. All the guys with deep potential, I'm not gonna re-sign because they're all terrible. Re-sign Tapia. Patterson will re-sign. Wait, he wants 5 years, though. Ooh. Well, from 3 years. 3 years. And we'll offer 1.5 mil. There you go. That seems a little bit more comfortable for me. But I have Derek Goins on here. He's a little bit too old for me. Any other dudes that are lower down? Ike Harmon. Already signed that guy. Derek, Ryan Castellini. Dom Nunes. I'll go and sign a whole bunch of players that are like C potential, even higher though, in the free agency that are like a little bit higher overall and a little bit more talent than the guys we have right now. You have Ben on here. Wait, how much does Ben want actually? He wants 500K. Offer him 1 year actually. And then we have Irvin. And then we have our big fish right here who wants 550K is Vladdy though. Vladdy wants 550K. So offer him that, I guess, because that's what he wants. And hopefully, wait. Does he want a depth role, though? I guess depth isn't going to have to be what he wants, though. That'll be alright. We have Tom Casey in here. We'll re-sign him. Jeff Hoffman wants... Okay, we'll offer Jeff that. That's alright. Then you have Johnny. Anybody else in here? Alejandro. Peter. Rufus. Riley Pint. Anyone else in here, though? Anyone else? Henry is alright, I guess. He's decent. You have Matt. He wants 790K. That's way too much, though, for me. He's only 60 overall, 26 years old, though. That's a little bit too old for me, though, that overall. We'll hold off for that. That one, like, you have Juan Beltran. Is that big potential? 29 years old. That's way too old for his overall, too. Anybody else? You have Jack Ridley, though. He's alright. Bring back Jack. We have Roy. We have Larry. Might as well bring him back. Eugene, I'm not going to bring back. And we do have, like, looks like Miguel Castro is all right there, too. Wait, how much does Miggy want? He wants way too much money, actually. We'll offer him like this. That's all right. Anyone else down here? We do have, like, Ron Sawyer. We re-sign him. Bring him back. We have Roger, and that's pretty much it, though, for the guys I want to bring back. So they have a lot of guys, like, D potential that I don't really want to bring back because they're too old. And some of the guys, they have B potential, but 58 overall, 29 years old, he's not going to develop pretty well for me. So I want guys who can develop in the system to basically bring back is what I want to do. So how much money do we actually have, though, on our team? How much money do we have? So you have $51 million in the pending. But where is our overall salary though? I want to see how much salary we have. So you have like $5 million in the bank, 3.38 for cash flow. So what do we have for salary though overall? Like Walden I might want to bring back, McGee I might want to bring back, but it all depends on how much salary you actually have though. So go sim through maybe the first few days, like where are we at actually? I have no clue what date we're on. So Salas is back, okay, so we have Salas back. We do have Robbie Ray back, John Gray's back, Anderson's back, Hoffman's back, LeMahieu's back, you have David Dahl is back, Trevor Story's back, Walters is back, and so on. That's it for day one. So day two, we have Blackman's back, cool, and that's about it. So how many people are left? I think that's pretty much all of them. That's pretty much it. So who should we bring back from this crop of talent? We do have Walden on here. Can we re-sign Walden? He's a great guy I want to bring back. So Walden, maybe bring him back on a contract. Do you bring him back on that? I might hold off for now. Jake McGee. He wants 2.9 per year. I mean, he played well for us, though. 1.96 ERA is amazing for a reliever guy. So bring him back on a two-year deal worth that. I think that's pretty much fair for us. And then we have Steven Wright. Steven Wright, is the right move re-signing him? I think it is, actually. He's pretty decent, though. He's all right. So bring him back in a one-year, two-year deal is not that bad for us. So right there, hopefully he comes back. You have Mark Reynolds. Mark Reynolds is not that bad either. So 1.9 mil for 1 year is not that bad for me. And then we have Tyler Chatwood. He wants 3.5 per year, which is a little bit too pricey for me. But he's all right, though. He's a 3.3 ERA is not that bad. And we could always trade him if we want to, too, because he's got a little bit of value to himself. So we'll bring him back there, I guess. And then we do have anyone else in here. Do we have anybody else? Doesn't look like it too much. Yeah, that's about it. So those are all the players I really want to bring back there. Hopefully I'll re-sign after this day, too. We have Steven Wright's back, Chatwood's back, McGee's back, Reynolds is back. And it looks like Cole's accepted the Angels offer for our pitching coach. Damn it, so he's gone. Any other coaches actually hired us? So where are our coaches, though, I want to sign? So pretty much all of them were number one. That's about it. So you have manager, pitching coach, and first base. Is that all we need? I think it's all we need. Yeah, that's about it. So in the next few days, hopefully everyone signs. Okay, now we do the first one. So Buster Iguchi is our new pitching coach for 3 years. Let's see him, though. So Buster Iguchi, though, A potential, he or A attribute grade, he looks great as our new pitching coach. So he'll be teaching up John Gray and the crew on how to pitch properly in the MLB. But what's so notable about this? School navigations. Okay, so only one more day until free agency. So do you have any other players we need to re-sign? Yeah, it doesn't look like it. So Jordan Walden could have free agency. So we could maybe figure something out between them, though. Maybe. Tom Murphy, should we bring him back? You know what, I might bring him back, actually. He's not that bad. Bring him back in the last day of before free agency. Chad Qualls, we'll leave him back, though. Wait, even Chad Qualls, though. I'm just E1, 1.5 mil. He had a great year last year. Should we bring him back? No, he's going to go down before the season, though. He's going to be like a 66 overall before the first day of spring training. So he's going to be terrible for us if we bring him back. So Walden, though, should we bring him back? That's the question. He's a great reliever guy, though. I know he's going to play well next season. Maybe lowball him a bit and see if he takes it, though. Or no, hold up. We'll wait. So how much money do we actually have going into this overall free agency? I want to see. So actually, we'll sim. So Tom Murphy's back before the first day of the free agency. We have our new manager, though. Jim Hickey is a new manager. And John Gibbons is going to be the manager for the Cubs. Okay. So John Gibbons was on there, though. So one guy was saying that looks like John Gibbons. I think that was John Gibbons. That's pretty cool. Ryan Heron is now our first base coach. Cool. So now, our first day of free agency. Who's our free agent for the season? Does it even say? Actually, no, it doesn't. Okay. So we're still left for that. But where is... Okay, there's a new bench coach. So there he is. So Jim Hickey is a new overall manager on the team. A overall attribute grade. He looks great as our new manager. We have Dale there as our hitting coach. Buster Iguchi as our new pitching coach. First base, we do have Ryan Heron. And then for third base, we do have Kevin Weinstein. And we have Errol Coker there as our farm director. So our team looks great there when it comes to the overall coaching staff, hopefully, so that attracts some more players that want to actually come to Colorado to play for the Rockies. Let's go see one more day and see what our free agents are for this season. So we have Yu Darvish on there, we have Michael Brantley, Andrew McCutcheon, Sean Kelly, we have Eric Hosmer, Adrian Beltre, Jose Bautista, Lorenzo Cain, Jordan Walden, obviously, Jose Reyes, Gerard Dyson. We have Gerard Dyson actually be pretty good to get. We have Francisco Rodriguez, Melvin Upton Jr., Brandon Phillips, Tyson Ross, and so on and so forth. It's a huge free agency, though. We can pick up some great players there in this free agency. So who do you pick up, though, and how do we do it? So who should we pick up, though? There's actually tons of options to go and maybe sign some great players in this overall free agency. But I'll go take a look at the roster and show you what players we actually need on this team. So as of right now, I'll go to our roster right now quickly before we do anything else. So on starting pitchers, we do need some more starting pitchers on this team for sure. Like Robbie Ray, you take a look at him, you think, oh, he's 72 overall. But the thing is, he's angry. That's why he's 72 overall. He's usually a 77. So he's gone up a bit for this season. But who do you need in this team, though? Well, Prince Shipley is now on the team. So Prince Shipley changes everything, though. Now we do have a guy who's a workhorse, and he's grounded. Okay, so we have Prince Shipley, who could go and maybe go in the MLB next season if we don't have any pitchers at all. You have Chatwood, Stephen Wright, John Gray. You have Tyler Anderson, and so on. So, you have a few other guys. Even Davis Enfield, too, is not that bad either. So, you have Davis Enfield and Shipley now in the system if we need them. So, I think you might need to go and sign another starter here. Maybe even sign an ace, possibly. Like, a guy is, like, maybe even 85 overall, 87 overall, something like that. That's higher than 84. But next up, though, is relief pitchers. We got to re-sign some more. We need to sign some more relief guys. Like, maybe it's another 73, 74 guy. Or even an 80 overall plus guy. Like, maybe even Jordan Wall and re-sign him, maybe. Then closing pitchers, we get to re-sign. Maybe sign a new closing pitcher. Catcher, we think we're good at catchers for now. Tony Walters might develop in a few years, so we're pretty good there for now. But first baseman, I think we're good for first base for now. Ian Desmond's doing great as of right now, but maybe sign a guy if we can get a guy cheaper. Like, maybe get another guy to go and hit on the bench, possibly. Second base, you have DJ LeMahieu, we're fine there. Third base, you have Nolan Arenado, Ryan McMahon, and that's about it. Shortstops, you do have Trevor Story, Pat Valaika, and Brandon Rodgers. Left field, you have David Dahl and Jordan Rivera. Center field, you have Blackman and Tapia. Then right field, we do have Jordan Patterson. We have Vladdy there at 64 overall. And Jason Erasmus. So our team, we need another outfielder for sure. Maybe another outfielder on this team. A new starting pitcher. And maybe even some more infield talent to go and play the bench possibly. Because we do have Anthony Ghost retired and Brad retired. So both our bench players are now gone. So we're going to sign a new speedy guy and a new... Actually, just even two speedy guys that can play the outfield and the infield would be great for our team. And plus, even sign some more like elite talent on our team, like some guys that stand out to me right now, or maybe like a Tyson Ross. Add him into the rotation would be good for us, too. Even have Alex Cobb there, too. He was on the trade block, and I wanted to acquire him. But now he's a free agent. Maybe we can go and do that right now. And we do have Yu Darvish in here, too. So Yu Darvish, I'd love to pick him up here. He'd be our ace automatically because he played great last season. So how much does you want, though? He wants 5 years, $104 million. So we do have the opportunity to go and sign Yu Darvish. We have the money, too. So maybe we can. That's the question. So our 2018 budget would be $104.1 million after this. So take up a huge chunk of our budget if we sign Yu Darvish. But you could also sign some more depth guys. Like relief, we do have, like, looks like Fernando Abad. You have Chad Qualsner who could probably re-sign. Jason Mott even bring him back there, too. You have Giuseppe and so on. So Walden, he seems like the best overall option to go and get a guy for relief, though. He played all right, I guess, last season. Maybe you can bring him back, too, a deal worth 4.6. So we do have that there on two. There are two. Closing pitchers, we have Sean Kelly there, too. We could maybe pick up there for backup talent, or even a starting talent, too, because we have Ottavino who could go to defer right to relief again. Then catcher, you have Miguel Montero there. We do have Soto, Avila. Even Avila wouldn't be that bad there, too, as a veteran catcher. First base, we do have Lucas Duda. You could probably pick up on there, too. Second base, you have Brandon Phillips. We have Danny Espinosa. Third base, you have Beltre and Plouffe. Shortstops, you have, looks like Jose Reyes, who's not that bad there either. Alcides Escobar is even great, too. So maybe even pick up Alcides as a guy who could play, maybe even, I don't know, backup role on the bench, possibly, if he wants to. I doubt you'd take that, but it'd be pretty cool to have Alcides Escobar on the bench. But any other speedy guys on this team? Any other speedy guys in this free agency? Jose Reyes is not that bad. Left field for Michael Brantley. It looks like the Indians lowballed him, actually. So we could go and bring Michael Brantley to Colorado if we want to, actually. He batted 316 last season, so it'd be great if we could pick up Michael Brantley on this team, though. Put him at right field. He'd automatically be a star in right field for us. And he actually fits the bill, though. He's got speed. He's got a little bit of... He got great contact, obviously. Great plate vision. Great fielding. I mean, he's our overall ideal right fielder to go and put in our lineup. So, Michael Brantley could maybe even sign him. Melvin up the junior, though, is a cheap option for our team. So, he's got great speed. Great... decent overall stealing. His fielding's all right. His contact's all right. And his power's all right there, too. So, there's one other option there for Melvin Upton Jr. We have Halby Kendrick down here too, who's all right. Matt Holliday, even Matt Holliday would be great there too. Anyone else in here? That's pretty much it. Then center field, we did have Lorenzo Cain there, 83 overall. Gerard Dyson there, who's a speed demon though. 97 speed, 96 stealing, huge for the team if we can pick him up. We have Curtis Granderson on there, and we do have Cameron Maybin. Then in right field, you have Andrew McCutchen there in right field. So McCutchen, I'd love to pick him up there too as a star role. So much as you want, actually. Only $11.9 million. So maybe bring Andrew McCutchen to Colorado might be a great idea. If we cannot get, obviously, Michael Brantley, maybe. So that actually could be a good idea. Bring McCutchen to Colorado. So what does he have there? Great contact, great overall power. Decent speed, decent fielding. He'd fit the bill, though, for sure, because right now he's almost being pushed out of Pittsburgh with, like, Gregory Polanco and Sterling Marte commanding the outfield. And they probably want to bring in a cheaper option out there, too, because it doesn't look like Polanco and Marte will be taking any pay cuts, though, for sure. So, but McCutchen could go and bring his talents to Colorado this offseason. Plus, we do have Jose Bautista in there, too, who's basically a power demon, though, too. Great overall power in this league. So you have Bautista and McCutchen there in right field, possibly. And then you do have this guy like Eddie Miranda to go and bring in as a prospect. And yeah, that's pretty much it there for star talent. So I guess going to end the episode off right here. Make sure to subscribe for more Rockies franchise bow. And thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.